the Battle of Maqongqo, fought from January 29, 1840, was a major turning point in Zulu history. It took place during the First Zulu Civil War, which was a power struggle between King Dingane and his brother Mpande. After years of military defeats, Dingane's powers had weakened, and Mpande saw an opportunity to take control of the Zulu kingdom. In this video, we'll be going through the background, events, and aftermath of this important battle. Royal and humble greetings to each and every one. In 1838, Dingane, the Zulu king, suffered devastating defeat at the hands of the Boer settlers led by Andries Pretorius in the Battle of Blood River. This defeat greatly weakened Dingane's authority. In an effort to strengthen his kingdom, Dingane tried expanding his territory but faced another defeat against the Swazi in 1839. Meanwhile, Mpande, Dingane's brother, feared for his life and believed Dingane would eliminate him as a rival. In response, Mpande fled with around 17,000 followers to escape his brother's reach. To gain power, Mpande made a deal with the Boer settlers. He promised them land and cattle in St. Lucia Bay if they helped him overthrow Dingane and became the new Zulu king. The Boers, who wanted access to the seaport not controlled by the British, eagerly agreed. Together, they launched a military campaign to remove Dingane from power. On January 14, 1840, Mpande's army, led by General Nongalaza Kanondele, entered Zululand with around 5,000 soldiers, called Impis. Now, Nongalaza Kanondele was a prominent Zulu warrior and military commander who played a critical role during King Mpande's rise to power in the Zulu kingdom. His military powers was first displayed when Mpande, then a chieftain of the Nyandwini clan, faced an invasion by Robert Biker and rebel Zulu forces. Nongalaza successfully led Mpande's troops in defeating these forces at the Thukela River in 1838. Nongalaza's most significant achievement came in 1840, when he commanded Mpande's primary army during the Zulu succession conflict against Dingane. While Mpande allied with the Boers and took a separate route under Andries Pretorius, Nongalaza promptly attacked Dingane's forces at the Battle of Maqongqo. Their relationship, however, became strained during the Zulu Civil War of 1856, when Mpande favored his younger son, Mbuyazi, and Nongalaza sided with him in opposition to Cetshwayo at the Battle of Ndodakusuka, which we'll be talking more about on the next video. Now, going back to this day of January 14, 1840, when Mpande's army was led by General Nongalaza Kanondele. After entering Zululand with around 5,000 soldiers or impis. Meanwhile, Mpande and the Boer forces led by Pretorius advanced separately. The Boers brought 308 armed men, 500 servants, and 50 wagons. Dingane tried to negotiate with Mpande, but Mpande and Nongalaza refused, showing they were determined to fight. Dingane's army, led by General Ndlela Kasumbisi, positioned themselves on the Maqongqo Hills. Ndlela Kasumbisi was also a prominent Zulu general and advisor who served under both kings Shaka and Dingane. Rising from humble beginnings as a non-Zulu warrior, Ndlela earned his place through exceptional skill in battle, mostly notable during the Ndwandwe Zulu War. He became Dingane's chief advisor and commander-in-chief of the Zulu army, holding high ranks in volatile political environment. Ndlela played a pivotal role in several important conflicts, including the Battle of Blood River and the Battle of Maqongqo. His most significant defiance came when he refused to kill Mbande, who was Shaka and Dingane's half-brother, preserving the royal lineage. This act, however, led to his execution by strangulation in 1840, after Dingane accused him of treason following his defeat against Mbande's forces. Ndlela's legacy endures, as Mbande, who succeeded Dingane, was married to Ndlela's daughter, ensuring that all subsequent Zulu monarchs descended from Mbande. A monument to Ndlela was erected in KwaZulu-Natal in 2004, honoring his role in Zulu history. Going back to the Battle of Maqongqo, both sides had about 5,000 soldiers and used the traditional Zulu military formation called the chest and horns, where the army's center engages the enemy while the flanks surround them. However, Dingane's soldiers were demoralized after their previous defeats, and many began deserting to Mbande's side. Nongalaza tricked Dingane's men by making them believe that the Boer forces were already there to support Mbande. As many of Dingane's soldiers deserted, General Ndlela ordered a retreat, but Nongalaza's forces slaughtered the wounded and even Dingane's wives. In anger, Dingane had Ndlela strangled to death for his failures. On February 6, 1840, the Boers finally arrived and declared Mbande the new king of the Zulus. They took 36,000 cattle as loot and returned to the Republic of Natalia. Dingane, now without any army or kingdom, fled to Swaziland. Sadly, he was murdered soon after by a Swazi and Nyawo patrol. On February 14, 1840, Pretorius issued a proclamation that a large portion of land extending from St. Lucia Bay would now form the boundary between the Zulu Kingdom and the Boer Republic of Natalia. The Battle of Maqongqo marked the end of Dingane's rule and the beginning of Mbande's reign as King of the Zulus. Mbande's victory and alliance with the Boers shaped the future of the Zulu Kingdom and the region. This moment in history is significant because it reflects the complex relationships between African kingdoms and European settlers during this time period. This battle was not just about military power, but also the shifting dynamics of leadership, alliances, and territory that would continue to influence South Africa for generations. Now that was the Battle of Maqongqo, also known as the First Zulu Civil War. If there's something that you feel like we forgot to mention, be sure to state it on the comment section. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up. Until the next one, Thank you for watching.